Hello there, everyone. My name's Andrew.
And I'm Kassy.
And this is the Culips English Podcast. Hello there, everyone. Welcome back to Culips. This is a simplified speech episode. Simplified speech is the series that features clear, natural conversations that are designed to help you boost your English listening skills and increase your knowledge of essential English vocabulary and ultimately help you get awesome at English. Today, I am joined by my co-host, Kassy, and we have a very sweet topic to talk about today, don't we, Kassy?
Yes, we are talking about desserts.
Yes, desserts. So we will get to that in just a moment. But before we do, I want to let all of our listeners know about the study guide for this episode. Guys, the best way to study with Culips is with our study guides, which we make for each and every one of our episodes. There's a lot of good stuff in the guides, like a transcript, detailed vocabulary explanations and examples. There's a comprehension quiz. There are prompts that you can use for speaking and writing practice, and more. So to get the guide, all you have to do is sign up and become a Culips member. And you can do that by visiting our website, culips.com. So today's episode was suggested to us by one of our Instagram followers, Summer Heart. And Summer Heart asked us to talk about desserts. And we are happy to oblige, aren't we, Kassy?
Yes, I love dessert.
Okay, so why don't we start with a definition of desserts? What does it mean to you, dessert?
I think traditionally it's sweet food that follows dinner.
Yeah. So I have the same idea of dessert. It is something that we eat after dinner that is sweet. And I think the idea behind dessert is that if you have something sweet after your main meal, it will signal to your brain that you have finished eating and that you shouldn't feel hungry anymore. I believe that was the original idea behind it. I have no idea if there is any scientific proof to support that claim, but I believe that's why people eat dessert after their meal.
Yeah, I have no idea either. I do know that tradition has spread and dessert is no longer simply an after meal pleasure, but pretty much an anytime you want kind of thing.
Kassy, what are some traditional American desserts?
I think it depends on how fancy you want to go. So you could have something as simple as fruits or a pudding, or you could have something really decadent like a dark chocolate cake, ice cream.
Pie.
Oh, pie. Yes, that is very American.
Yes. What is the expression, as American as apple pie?
Yep, that's right.
What about in your house growing up? Did you eat dessert after dinner?
Yeah, we were a really big dessert family. My mom loves to bake, and she instilled that love in me. I also love baking. So our family really loved to bake cookies and cakes.
Cookies and cakes. Now, would you eat a cookie or a cake every night for dessert, or was it a once in a while kind of thing?
Our family was really busy, especially my mother. So desserts were typically a holiday thing, actually. We would, you know, binge eat tons of cookies from Thanksgiving till Christmas and then kind of stop for a couple of months, detox.
I see. Yeah, I think that's true for a lot of people when the weather starts to get a little bit colder and you're spending more time inside. You start to bake more often. And of course, with baking comes binging, you know, if you eat one cookie, it's hard to stop eating another one and another one, right?
Yes. How about your family, Andrew? Were you guys regular dessert eaters or similar to my family?
I think we would have dessert, of course, not every night, but I think more often than you. Like, I remember eating dessert once or twice a week, but it wasn't usually like cake. Cake, we would eat really only on special occasions. Somebody's birthday, of course, we would eat birthday cake. Or maybe if we had company over for dinner, like if my aunt and uncle from out of town were visiting, maybe my mom would bake a cake for that situation. Or if some family friends visited for a dinner party, we would maybe have a cake in that situation. But usually what we would eat for dessert would be fruit or ice cream. So I remember eating a peach after dinner or eating some vanilla ice cream with peaches. I think this was the most common thing that we would eat for dessert in my house.
Yeah, I think it depends on the season. Pennsylvania is famous for their strawberry season. So we would actually have dessert for dinner sometimes. We would have strawberry shortcake for maybe 2 weeks in the summer.
Whoa, that's awesome. Yeah, now that you mention it, my hometown is really a big fruit producing place. So there are many orchards and the farmers grow apples, cherries, peaches, grapes, many different kinds of fruit. And in the fall, we would eat a lot of food that was centered around apples. Apples are the main ingredient. So my mom would make apple crisp, which we would eat for dessert, which is really delicious.
I love apple crisp. Oh, I'm nostalgic. I want some now.
So for people who don't know what apple crisp is, it's an apple dessert that is layered. So there are apples on the bottom and then they are covered with cinnamon and oats and brown sugar, usually, maybe some other things.
Don't forget the butter.
Butter, lots of butter. Yes, lots of butter. And then it is baked for a while until all of that kind of caramelizes and the apples become soft. And it just is really delicious. I love it even to this day. And yeah, we would usually eat that with a scoop of vanilla ice cream, to be honest with you.
It's kind of like a deconstructed apple pie.
That's another dessert that we would eat in the fall from time to time is apple pie. I do remember baking some pies with my mom when I was younger, but it's a difficult dessert to make. Baking a pie is not easy, especially if you do it from scratch. So I think most of the time we just visited the bakery and bought some store-bought pies.
That's a great word you used there, Andrew. From scratch.
Yeah, from scratch.
It sounds like we were pretty lucky. We grew up in a household where our moms or somebody would make desserts from scratch. But some families, they don't have that experience. They only get desserts that are store-bought or from a restaurant.
Yeah, so from scratch means to make something yourself, right? With all of the ingredients, and then you put the ingredients together to make the desserts. Whereas the opposite of from scratch is store-bought, where you go to a store and you buy the cake or the pie or the whatever dessert it is already prepared for you.
Which can be also very delicious, but they're missing that component of love that comes with desserts made from scratch.
Now, Kassy, you mentioned just a second ago about how some people only ever ate desserts at a restaurant or from the store. So why don't we talk about ordering desserts at a restaurant? Now, personally, I rarely eat dessert at a restaurant. It's something that the servers will always ask you about. They'll come around to your table and say something like, "So, you guys thinking about dessert? What do you think? Can I tempt you with the dessert menu?" They'll ask you this question. But usually I don't eat dessert at a restaurant. How about you? Is this something that you would typically order?
I don't know about Canadian restaurants, but American restaurants tend to give ginormous portion sizes. So I wasn't too hungry for dessert, but my mom has a really big sweet tooth. So maybe we would order one dessert and share it with the whole family.
Mm-hmm.
And we would love to order the chocolate lava cakes. Those were really famous. It's mm-hmm, a chocolate mm-hmm. cake with the inside having like a molten, gooey chocolate center. It's really good.
Yeah.
What else? Skillet baked chocolate chip cookies. Like a giant chocolate chip cookie baked in a skillet.
Mm-hmm. A skillet is a type of cast iron pan, mm-hmm. correct?
Yes.
So that it would be very crispy on the bottom.
And gooey in the middle. So good.
Yes. Yes, that's a good combination. Crispy on the outside, soft and gooey in the middle.
And then I think ice cream would be the last really typical restaurant dessert.
Mm. All right. Yeah, I guess the nice thing about ordering dessert at a restaurant is you can get these desserts that are difficult to make at home, right?
Mm.
Like the lava cake, that's tough to make at home. The big cookie made on the skillet. It's a lot of work to do at home, but if you order it at a restaurant, you can kind of splurge and treat yourself.
That is very true. Or getting flavors that, you know, would be hard to come by, like maybe a dark chocolate raspberry cheesecake. Not everybody has cheesecake products and raspberry filling in their house.
Yeah. And some of these desserts can be quite expensive to make, like a black raspberry cheesecake. So ordering it at a restaurant is a more affordable thing to do. Plus, if you start binging on a big cheesecake after you make it, that's not a very good scene. Not good for your health. Kassy, we'll leave it at here for today. But before I let you go, I have to ask you one last question, which is, what's your favorite dessert? If you had to pick just one, what would you choose?
Oh, so hard to choose. But if I had to, I think I would pick a simple vanilla cake with chocolate icing.
All right. And I'm going to select the apple crisp with vanilla ice cream that I mentioned earlier. Just thinking about it now has my mouth watering a little bit. So everyone, thank you for tuning in and studying English with us today. We are glad that you showed up and put in some study time with us. To recap this episode, we talked about desserts and learned some cool expressions like from scratch and store-bought. If you enjoyed this episode and found it educational and entertaining, then please consider supporting us. You can do that in a variety of ways. You could become a paid Culips member. And guys, we really couldn't keep doing Culips without the support of our members. We appreciate our members so much. So to sign up and become a member, just visit culips.com. But that's not the only way to support us. You could also leave us a 5-star rating and a positive review on your favorite podcast app, like Apple Podcasts. Or you could tell your friends about the Culips English Podcast. Finally, why not follow us on social media? We are all over the place on Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter. If you have a question or a topic or a suggestion for an upcoming Culips episode topic, then drop us a line and get in touch. Our email address is contacts@culips.com. And we'll be back soon with another brand new episode. So we'll talk to you then. Goodbye.
See ya.